Allahu, 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 Allah.
My brothers and sisters, nowadays, as we are witnessing this month called Rabi' al-Awwal, we found that a lot of people on social media, they exchange messages about the welcoming of the birthday of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. In a lot of social media, people, they exchange messages amongst one another about the Mawlid al-Nabawi. So, is this the right of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam only merely to exchange greetings amongst one another and people sending messages writing Allahumma salli ala Muhammad 100 times, share it, and people keep sharing messages? Is this really the haqq of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam? Who is he? Is this really the merits of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam? Is this how we show love of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam? Man huwa hada rajul? Who is he? Who is he? What do you know really about him, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just so you know, the merits of your Prophet, my Prophet, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, just so you know, Allah Azza wa Jal, He creates and He favors. وَرَبُّكَ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ وَيَخْتَارُ. Your Lord, He creates and He selects. Allah Azza wa Jal created the seven heavens and He favored the seventh one. He created the seventh heavens, the seven skies, favored the seventh sky. The heavens, all the heavens, Allah Azza wa Jal favored Al-Firdaws Al-A'la. Allah created the angels, and from all the angels, Allah favored three. Jibreel, Mikael, and Israfil. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created nations. Umam, nations. From all the nations, Allah favored this nation. Kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat linnas. Ta'muruna bilma'rufi wa tanhawna 'anil munkar. You were the best nation that came out. You enjoin good and you forbid evil. The Prophet Muhammad ﷺ says in this hadith, very sound and authentic, أنتم موفون سبعون أمة أنتم أحبها وأكرمها إلى الله. You'll be coming along 70 other nations. You are the most beloved nation in the sight of Allah. Allah creates and He favors and He selects. Allah created mankind. From all mankind, Allah favored the prophets. Then Allah favored the messengers. Then Allah favored from all the prophets and messengers, five. We call them Ulul Azm. Five. Nuh, Ibrahim, Musa, Isa, wa Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And from those five, Allah favored Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and He made him the seal of all prophets and messengers sallallahu alayhi wasallam. If you read the Quran, you will find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He addresses the prophets, He addresses them by name, except Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Adam, uskun anta wa zawjuka al-jannah. Ya Nuh, ihbit bi salamin minna wa barakat. Ya Ibrahim, qad saddaqta al-ru'ya. Ya Musa, inni ana Allah. Ya Isa, inni mutawaffika wa rafi'uka ilayk. يا زكريا إنا نبشرك بغلام اسمه يحيى. يا يحيى خذ القتاب بقوة. Except Prophet Muhammad. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses him, He says, يا أيها النبي. يا أيها الرسول. يا أيها المدثر. يا أيها المزمل. But when He mentions His name, He says, محمد Rasulullah. Muhammadun Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What is it that you and I know about him? What are his merits? Nobody knows the rights of Prophet Muhammad except the one who created Prophet Muhammad, Allah. Allah. La ahad ya'raf qadr al-nabi illa alladhi khalaq al-nabi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabb al-nabi, ya'raf qadr al-nabi. His rights, his values, his merits, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah Azza wa Jal has singled him out with many favors. خَصَّهُ بِخَصَائِصَ عَدِيدًا. One of the favors that Allah has blessed him with or singled him out with is something called الشَّفَاعَة. الشَّفَاعَة. خَصَّهُ اللَّهُ بِالشَّفَاعَة. And some people think that Prophet Muhammad has only one shafa'ah. لا, he has many shafa'at. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The greatest shafa'ah that he has, one of the greatest shafa'ah, we call it al-shafa'ah al-uzma. The greatest shafa'ah is this shafa'ah intercession. This intercession, the greatest intercession, is this intercession that involves all mankind in the land of the mahshar, in the land of resurrection, where people will be naked, barefooted, the sun on top of their heads. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, in this land, as Allah says in the Quran, في يوم كان مقداره خمسين ألف سنة, in a day equivalent to 50,000 years. People standing, sun on top of their heads, naked, barefooted. Nobody will care about nobody else. Comes bunch of believers. Let's go and ask for someone to give us shafa'ah, to intercede. Shafa'ah for what? Is this the shafa'ah to enter Jannah? La. This is only the shafa'ah for Allah to come down and solve the hisab. People will be sweating so much that day. Everybody from the day Allah created mankind until the end of time. All gathered in this land called the land of al-mahshar. Some people will wish to die. Then go through it. And then they will go to Adam. Yeah, Adam. They will ask Adam first. Allah created you from his hand. Ala tara ma nahnu fi? Don't you see what we're enduring, O Adam? Ishfa' lana. Ishfa' lana. Intercede on our behalf. Adam will say, Inna Allah ghadib al-yawma ghadab lam yaghdab mithlahu qablahu wa lan yaghdab mithlahu ba'da. Idhhabu ila ghayri, idhhabu ila ghayri. Nafsi, 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 nafsi. Adam will say, Allah has become so furious today. So angry today. He has never become this furious. And he will never become this angry. Go to somebody else. Go to Ibrahim. Go to Nuh. Myself, 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 myself. Even the prophets will say, myself, myself. Go to Nuh. Ya Nuh, Allah sent you. You lived 950 years. The first prophet that came out, Ya Nuh, ishfa' lana, intercede. Nuh will say the same thing. And then he will mention, you know, go to Musa. Go to Ibrahim. We will go to Ibrahim. These believers, they go to Ibrahim. Ibrahim will say the same thing. Nafsi, nafsi. Myself, myself. Petrified. Scared. Terrified. He will say, myself, myself. Go to Musa. Musa is also scared. He killed a life. He's scared. He will say the same thing. And he will say, go to Isa. Jesus, peace be upon him. Go to Jesus. Go to Isa. Isa will go, will say, go to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi. Even Isa will say, myself, myself. Isa will say, nafsi, nafsi. Go to Muhammad. What do you think Prophet Muhammad will say? He will say, ana laha, ana laha. I am for it, I'm for it. And he will go. And he will make sujood. Before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yaqul, thumma yaftahu Allahu alayya bimahamida lam akun alamha min qabl. Allah Azza wa Jalla blesses me with some supplications which I've never known before. So I start supplicating Allah, glorifying him, praising him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would tell Prophet Muhammad, Ya Muhammad, irfa' ra'asak, sal tu'ta wa shfa' tu shafa'. Oh Muhammad, raise your head, ask, you shall be given, intercede, you shall be given intercession. Muhammad will say, Ummati, Ummati. My nation, my nation. He would not say, Fatima, my daughter, Aisha, my wife. He will say, Ummati, Ummati, this man, which a lot of us have ignored his sunan, he will say, Ummati, Ummati. Ummati, Ummati. Nafs, Ummati. My nation, my nation. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will address Prophet Muhammad. Go, I'm coming. And Allah will come down to start the hisab. This is the first shafa'ah. Then other shafa'at. Like the Prophet will intercede for people who are committing major sins for Allah to forgive them. Prophet Muhammad will also intercede for some people who gone to hellfire to come out from hellfire. The Prophet Muhammad will intercede for people to join him in Jannah, to be with him in Jannah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah Azza wa Jal has favored him with something called Al-Hawd. Al-Hawd, the basin of Al-Kawthar. Inna a'tayna kal-Kawthar. Al-Kawthar, this river which Allah Azza wa Jal has favored Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with. A river. Prophet Muhammad is also a river. But what kind of river? A river of mercy. Rahmah. Inna arsalnaka rahmatan lil alameen. Allah says, we have sent you rahmah to all mankind, not only to Muslims. Not only to Muslims. Rahmah lil alameen. To the worlds. Humans, jinn, ins, even to animals. Rahmah, rahmah, rahmah. A river of rahmah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Here he is. Who? Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What is he doing? Where is he now? He's in his home house. The house of Aisha. At night. Sleeping. Putting his head on the lap of Aisha. On the chest of Aisha. Aisha, at night. She remembered something and she cried. One of her tears fell on the cheek of the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ. He woke up, found her crying. Ya Aisha tabkeen? Ma yubkiki ya Aisha? Oh Aisha, you're crying. Why are you crying on Aisha? Why do you think Aisha is crying? Is it because of her home that's so small? That she doesn't have no carpet, she doesn't have no light, she doesn't have no goods, she doesn't have no food, she doesn't have no camels, no horses, no, like her other sisters. Why is she crying? How's her home? Her home is 11 by 9. The ceiling is no concrete. Palm leaves. On the corner, a rug from palm leaves where the Prophet would sleep and also make qiyam al-layl. Khalas. This is the house of Rasulullah. This is it. Aisha's crying. Why? Don't you like what's going on here? Why are you crying, Ya Aisha? Ya Rasulullah, tadhakkartu yawm al-qiyamah. O Prophet of Allah, I remember the day of judgment and I started crying. Ya Rasulullah, ayadhkuru al-mar'u ahlahu yawm al-qiyamah? Ayadhkuru al-mar'u ahlahu? O Prophet of Allah, would a man remember his loved ones in the day of judgment? The Prophet ﷺ says, Ya Aisha, a man would not know anybody in three instances. He will forget about everyone in three instances. First instance is when you cross in the Sirat. You will not know nobody, you will not care about anybody. يوم تضع كل مرضعة عما أرضعت وتذهل كل مرضعة يوم تضع كل ذات حمل حملها وتذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى. A mom who's also carrying her baby, she will drop her baby. The mom sucking her baby, she'll drop her baby. Nobody will care about anybody else. As crossing the Sirat, until a man would secure himself crossing the Sirat and moving into Jannah. In Sirat, nobody will care about nobody else. The second instance, Ya Aisha, عند تطاير الصحف. When the book of scrolls, the book of records have been given, nobody will care about anybody else. Until the man makes sure that he will get his book of records with his right hand. The third instance is عند الموازين, in the scales. Nobody will care about anybody else until the man makes sure that his way is filled with hasanat versus sayyat. In these three instances, nobody will care about nobody else. Except even Prophet Muhammad. Look, Anas came to him. Ya Rasulullah, ishfa' li yawm al-qiyamah. Qala af'al ya Anas, af'al. Oh Rasulullah, intercede on my behalf on the day of judgment. I need your help. The Prophet says, I will do, oh Anas, I will do, oh Anas. Then Anas says, ayna ajiduk? Oh Prophet, where would I find you? Prophet Muhammad says, the first place where you would find me is at the Sirat. At the end of the Sirat. Every time a man from the Ummah of Rasulullah crosses the Sirat, the Prophet is in the other hand saying, oh Allah, help him. Oh Allah, help him. Allah, the Prophet Muhammad is making dua for each member of his family, of his Ummah, to cross the Sirat safely. The second place is عند الحوض. You will find me there. If you don't find me, you will find me by the basin. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as I mentioned, has given the basin to the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salam, so people will be coming to drink. The day when the sun is on top of the head, people are thirsty.
Some people will come to drink from the basin of Al-Kawthar, Al-Hawd of Al-Kawthar. And some people will drink directly from the hands of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam.
And some people will come to drink and they will be prevented by angels. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam would say, they're from my ummah, let them in, let them in.
The angels will say, La ya Prophet Muhammad, you don't know what they have innovated after you were gone.
You don't know what they have innovated. These are the people who claim that they love Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam.
The angels will say, you don't know what they have innovated after you were gone. Then Prophet Muhammad will say, suhqan, 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 suhqan. Take them, take them, take them, take them. The third place, Ya Anas, is عند الموازين. At the place of the scales again, you will find me there. You will find me there. All the other prophets, again, would say, Nafsi, Nafsi. Prophet Muhammad is there running right, left, and center, helping and making du'a for his ummah to go through. This is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. This is the prophet that we need to tell other people about, that we need to tell our children about, our friends about, our spouses about, our families about. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, this river of mercy, may Allah azza wa jal make us all witness him, see him in the day of judgment. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. Bismillahi walhamdulillahi wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. What are some of the rights? There's so many rights. The rights of Prophet Muhammad alayhi wasallam is that you love him. You must love him. And all of you say, yes, I do love Prophet Muhammad. But what does it really mean to love him sallallahu alayhi wasallam? You believe in him. You will not taste the halawat al-iman. You will not taste the sweetness of iman until you love this man more than you love yourself. Umar came to Rasulullah. Ya Rasulullah, wallahi, I love you. I love you more than anything else except myself. I love you more than my children, more than my spouse, more than my family, except me. Prophet says, no, Ya Umar, you will not be fully believer until you love me more than you love anything else, including yourself. Then Umar says, Ya Rasulullah, wallahi, I love you more than anything else, including myself. It's not like a mere talk. Loving Prophet Muhammad, you have to love what Prophet Muhammad used to love. Prophet Muhammad loves salah. Do you love salah? Prophet Muhammad loves Qiraat al-Quran. Do you love Qiraat al-Quran? Prophet Muhammad loves Sadaqah. Do you love Sadaqah? Prophet Muhammad loves Qiyam al-Layl. Do you love Qiyam al-Layl? Praying at night? Love what he loves, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Another right of Prophet Muhammad is that you convey his message. قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي أَدْعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَى بَصِيرَةٍ أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي قُلْ Say that this is my path, I call towards Allah, me and whoever follows me. بَلِّغُ عَنِّي وَلَوْ آيَةٍ بَلِّغُ عَنِّي Convey, even if you know one ayah, convey that ayah to people. This is the right of Prophet Muhammad, that you convey his message, the message of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لَيَبْلُغَنَّ هَذَا الدِّينِ مَا بَلَغَ اللَّيْلُ وَالنَّهَارِ وَلَيْتَكَ اللَّهُ بَيْتَ مَدَرٍ وَلَا وَبَرٍ إِلَّا أَدْخَلَهُ اللَّهُ هَذَا الدِّينِ بِعِزِّ عَزِيزٍ أَوْ بِذُلِّ دَلِيلٍ The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in this hadith reported by Tabarani and narrated by Samim al-Dari that the Prophet says that this religion will reach the four corners of the world. There will not be one single house remain in the entire universe that has not heard of something called La ilaha illallah. Peacefully, no bloodshed, no bloodshed. This religion will spread as Prophet Muhammad has promised peacefully. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But it needs you. Or in fact, you need it. Islam is spreading, whether you like it or not. The question is, what is your role? And finally, because I'm run out of time, another right of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is that you send salah upon him. As simple as that. Salat upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. When you hear his name, you say, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Allahumma salli wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Prophet Muhammad in Sahih Muslim said, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, man salla alayhi marratan sallallahu bi alayha ashra. Whoever sent one salat upon me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send salat upon him 10 times. 10 times. In another hadith classified Sahih Shaykh al-Albani rahmatullah alayhi qal, he says that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, in this hadith, he says, whosoever makes one salat upon me, one salat,
يعني you say اللهم صل على نبينا محمد or you say اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد you know like the dud as we say in Urdu you know this you have this these two you know options or versions as long as you send yourself upon Prophet Muhammad if you do it once Prophet Muhammad says Allah سبحانه وتعالى will give you 10 حسنات erase 10 سيئات 10 bad deeds and he will raise you 10 ranks in Jannah. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد اللهم صل على نبينا محمد اللهم صل وسلم على نبينا محمد اللهم ارزقنا من يده الشريفة شربة هنيئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا اللهم يا رب ارزقنا شفاعته I ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to grant us the shafa of the Prophet Muhammad I ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to give us the ability to be with him in Jannah To be with him in Jannah. A man came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from the Ansar. He says, Ya Rasulullah, a day comes where I think if I don't see you, I may die. I may die. I miss you. I love you so. And I think about it sometimes that if I were not to see you, I may die, Ya Rasulullah. And then he starts crying. The Prophet says, Why are you crying? I'm here. I'm here. He says, Ya Rasulullah, in Jannah. In Jannah. You'll be in a very high level. How about me? When I miss you in Jannah, how am I going to see you in Jannah? The Prophet didn't have the answer. All of a sudden, Allah Azza wa Jalla revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَا يُطْعِ اللَّهُ وَالرَّسُولُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مِنَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ وَحَسُنَ أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا Whosoever obeys Allah and his prophets, they will be resurrected with the prophets and the righteous. And the truthful ones and the martyrs. All you have to do, believe in Prophet Muhammad. Revive his sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad. Inshallah, you will be resurrected with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. اللهم اهدنا في من هديت وعافينا في من عافيت وتولنا في من توليت اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى اللهم أدنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأدنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه اللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك اللهم يا مصرف القلوب صرف قلوبنا على طاعتك اللهم لا تدع لنا في مقامنا هذا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا دينا إلا قضيته ولا ضالا إلا هديته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا ممسوسا إلا شفيته ولا معيونا ولا مسحورا إلا شفيته ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا والآخرة إلا وقضيت يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام واجعلنا اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام واجعلنا منهم واخذل من خذل دين محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام ولا تجعل أحدا من المسلمين منهم اللهم يا أرحم الراحمين يا مجيب استجب لدعائنا يا رحيم ارحمنا يا رحمن ارحمنا يا كريم أكرمنا يا لطيف اطف بنا يا غفور اغفر لنا يا غفار اغفر لنا يا عفو اعف عنا يا عفو اعف عنا يا قوي قوينا يا مجيب استجب لدعائنا يا مجيب استجب لدعائنا يا شافي اشفي مرضانا يا شافي اشفي مرضانا برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين اللهم ان نسينا فلا ننسى والدينا اللهم ارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا اللهم ارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا والدينا والدينا اللهم ارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا الاحياء منهم اغفر لهم اغفر لهم تجاوز عنهم يا رب العالمين اهدهم احسن اليهم يا رب العالمين والاموات منهم اغفر لهم تجاوز عنهم نور مدخلهم انس وحشتهم امن روعتهم نقهم من الخطايا كما ينقى الثوب الابيض من الدنس اغسلهم من الخطايا بالماء والثلج والبرد عباد الله ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون واقم الصلاه